Welcome to Region 1, also known as Ilocos Region. So let's proceed. Region 1. The history of Region 1. In 1571, the Spanish conquistador began looking for a new site to conquer. Legazpi grandson Juan de Salcedo volunteered to lead one of these expeditions. On June 13, 1572, Salcedo and his men landed in Vigan. They were surprised to see numerous sheltered cover look where the local lives in harmony. The location of the region is located in the northwest of Luzon. In its eastern border are regions of Cordillera Administrative Region and Cagayan Valley. And in the south is central Luzon. To the west north is the West Philippine Sea. The region is composed of four provinces, namely Ilocos Norte, Ilocos Sur, La Union, Pangasinan. Its regional center is San Fernando, La Union. The culture and tradition in Region 1. Ilocos are ruling ethnicity in Region 1. They constitute the majority of population in the Ilocos region, particularly in Ilocos Norte, 97%. In Ilocos Sur, 97%, La Union, 92%, and Pangasinan, 45%. Minority group include Tingguan and Isneg communities who inhabit the foothill of the Cordillera Mountains. Two ethnic groups still reside in Digras, Isneg and Yapayaw. This tribe were two of the first inhabitants of the region. They were forced to retreat to the mountain after they lost the battle against the Spanish troops. So now, let's begin to explore the Region 1, Ilocos Norte. The first province in Region 1 is Ilocos Norte, also known as the Northern Tourist Destination. So, before we proceed, we're going to tackle this history and creation, province and city, towns, geographical features, language, major ethnic groups. History and creation. The capital of Ilocos Norte is Lawag City. The Spanish colonization of the region, however, was never completely successful. On February 2, 1818, a Spanish royal decree was promulgated dividing the province of Ilocos Norte from Ilocos Sur. Province and major cities, town, geographical features. Ilocos Norte has a total land area of 3,400 square kilometers. Ilocos Norte has 557 barangays comprising its 21 municipalities and 2 cities. Major cities, towns are Bangi Windmill Farm, Lawag City, Pagudpod. Port of access. Via bus, public buses are available day and night. Several buses companies such as Florida, Partas, Fariñas, and Maria de Leon have regular trips directly bound to Lawag City. Normally, travel time takes around 10 to 12 hours by day and 8 to 10 hours at night. Day trip takes longer due to traffic along the municipalities and cities that you will pass by. For Via Air, Cebu Pacific, Philippine Airlines, and Airfield Express have scheduled flight daily to Lawag City. I suggest check their website time to time to catch out for discount and promo fare offered by this airline. Travel time is 45 minutes approximately. And the local transportation, they have tricycle taxis. So let's move on to major attraction, natural and man-made. The first one is the Sinking Bell Tower. If Italy has a Leaning Tower of Pisa, here in Lawag has its own local version. Sinking Bell Tower, which is located at the heart of the city. This edifice is the one of the tallest bell tower in the country. As of today, as it stands 45 meters tall, it is said to be sinking because the tower is so heavy and was built on sandy ground, which make it sink considerably into the ground at the rate of 1 inch every year. Normally, bell tower is near the church, but this tower is suited far away from the cathedral. At night, one can witness the beauty of the tower when lighted on. The second major attraction in Ilocos Norte is La Paz Sand Dunes. You don't need to visit Sahara Desert in Africa or in the desert found in the Middle Eastern country. Just come and visit this unique geological desert environment, which is found only in Ilocos Norte. The La Paz Sand Dunes, which was created by interaction of the wind, sea, and river, The height of the sand dunes range from 10 to 30 meters. The sand dunes are accessible by tricycle or jeepney. It just takes 15 minutes away from the city proper. Due to its desert-type environment, it is a popular location for shooting film, whether local or international filmmaker. Notable film include Himala and Panday for local movie and segments of the Hollywood film such as Mad Max and Born on the 4th of July. The third major attraction in Ilocos Norte is Paway Church. Paway Church is the national treasure of Ilocanja, a prime example of Baroque church, and it is considered as one of the UNESCO World Heritage Site. It was built in 1896 by Augustinian friars using coral bricks as seen from its massive wall. Its picture view truly bring you to what the Spanish era feels, such as those enormous and magnificent buttresses on the side and back of the building. From Lovag City, it's just 30 minutes ride to visit this tourist attraction in Paway. Once you visit the Malacañang of the North in Suba, go straight ahead to visit this place. So let's move on to Capurpurawan Rock Formation. Capurpurawan Rock Formation is situated in Burgos, Ilocos Norte from the National Highway. One will traverse along the winding dirty road. No public transportation goes inside the area, so it must to have your own car rather than walking under the heat of the sun. Due to its white color characteristic, its name was derived in Ilocano word Puraw means white. The rock looked like a large dragon catching over the entire coast. Once you reach it, you will enjoy the catching its natural beauty as this created by the waves of the ocean for so many years. Lastly, the most major attraction in Ilocos Norte, Bangi Windmill. Bangi Windmill is the first of its kind in Southeast Asia. It has 23 blades, 70-meter-high windmill, arranged in arc formation along the Bangi Bay. It is situated north of Lavag City and about 45 minutes ride. Ilocos Norte is the one of the province of the Philippines that generates renewable energy. The Bangi Windmill Farm supplies 40% of needs of Ilocos Norte Electric Cooperative. All in all, it was generated 25 megawatts of electricity to power up the estimated 108,000 households. The activities that you need to try in Ilocos Norte are: visit the biggest church in Ilocos Norte, climb up the Cape Bujador Lighthouse, bite into local delicacies, step back into history, go sandboarding and ride in 4x4 at the sand dunes, visit a heritage sites. For accommodation, I highly recommend Hanas Hotel and Resort. Hanas Beach Resort and Convention Center is 7-hectare property located in Pagudpud, Ilocos Norte. It is situated along the shore of the famous Blue Lagoon, a picturesque in pristine white sand beach that is partially enclosed by the range of mountain and cliff embracing the place, forming into a cove that is natural shelter of beauty and charm. Food and gastronomy. Bagnet is the most famous food in Ilocos Norte. Bagnet, locally also known as chicharon in Ilocano, is a Filipino dish consisting of pork belly. And the second famous food in Ilocos is longanisa. And the third is pinakbet. In festival, Farmers Festival Ilocos Norte. In May 19, Baraka Festival that highlight a street dance parade participated in by dressed up farmer with their product. Agro-industrial trade fair contest of the biggest farm harvest and livestock pinaka contest agro products. For the industry, the province specialized in the following products: corn, garlic, rice, tobacco, and loom weaving. So let's move on in Ilocos Sur. So before we proceed, we're going to tackle this following: history and creation, province and city, towns, geographical feature, language, major ethnic groups. History and creation. The Spanish arrived in 16th century and established Christian mission and governmental institution to control the native population and convert them to Catholicism.
On July 1574, the Spaniard explorer Don Juan de Salcedo and member of his expedition arrived in Vigan. A royal decree on February 2, 1818 separated in Ilocos from the Ilocos Sur, the latter to include the northern part of La Union as far as Namakapan, now Luna, and all of what is now the province of Juan. Province and major cities, town geographical features. Ilocos Sur comprises 32 municipality and 2 component city. Ilocos Sur is a province in the Philippines located in Ilocos region in Luzon. Its capital is the city of Bigan, located off the mouth of Mestizo River. Ilocos Sur has an area of 2,579.60 square kilometers. Ilocos Sur is bordered by Ilocos Norte and Abra to the north, Mountain Province to the east, La Union and Benguet to the south, and the South China Sea to the west. The major cities and towns are Vigan, Baluarte, Zoo, Bantay, Watchtower. Language and major ethnic group. The third largest Filipino ethnolinguistic group aside from Ay from the Look as Samtoy from Ilocano face, Samiditoy meaning our language here. The word Ilocano came from the word Iloco. Port access via bus. Public buses are available day and night. Several buses companies such as Florida, Paratas, Fariñas, and Maria de Leon have regular trips directly bound to Lawag. Normally, travel time takes around 10-12 hours by day and 8 hours to 10 hours at night. Day trip takes longer due to traffic along the municipalities that you will bypass. For via air, Cebu Pacific, Philippine Airlines, and Airfield Express have scheduled flight daily to Lawag City. I suggest to check their website time to time to catch out the discount and promo fare offered by this airline. This time travel is 45 minutes approximately. For the local transportation, they have tricycle taxis in Ilocos Sur. The first major attraction is Bantay Watchtower. The People Watchtower, it was built in 1591, well known as Filipino Film Panday. Vigan or Cali Crisologo is the one of the famous major attraction in Ilocos Sur. The Ilocos region was already thriving, fairly advanced cluster of town and settlements familiar to Chinese, Japanese, and Malay trader when the Spaniard explorer Don Juan de Salcedo and the member of expedition arrived in Vigan on June 13, 1572. Forthwith, they made Kabigbigaan or Vigan, the heart of Ilocos settlement, their headquarters, which is Salcedo called Villa Fernandina, and which eventually gained fame as Intramuros of Ilocanja. Salcedo declared the whole northern Luzon as encomienda or land grant. Subsequently, he became the encomendero of Bigan and lieutenant governor of Ilocos until his death in July 1574. One of the famous attractions in Ilocos Sur is the Baluarte Resort and Mini Zoo. It's just 10 minutes away from Cali Crisologo, Baluarte Resort and Mini Zoo lets you get close to nature, wonder creature from cute little birds to big cats aka tiger. This Vigan Ilocos tourist spot is also dubbed as the home of the big cats in Vigan, as it shelters Bengal tiger, white lion, and leopards. The activities that you need to try in Ilocos Norte are 1. Cali Crisologo. If you want to travel back in time, Cali Crisologo is the best place to be. This tourist spot is Vigan City. It's a street-old Spanish structure, mostly houses of wealthy families and Filipino-Chinese traders. 2. The Bantay Church Bell Tower. Bantay Church Bell Tower served as the town watchtower in 1591. The magnificent view that this tourist attraction in Ilocos Sur may have been the reason why it supposedly. Diego and Gabriel silang favorite date spot during the 17th century. Lastly, Pagbornayan Jar Factory. When someone gives you a jar from Vigan City, know that it's a good quality among the most famous jar factories in the province. It's the Pagbornayan Jar Factory. Here they make the jar from the grade A clay which is abundant in the area. For the accommodation, I highly recommend Vegan Plaza Hotel. Vegan Plaza Hotel is one of the best places to start a walking tour of the city. The property is right at the end of Calle Crisologo, and you can easily make your way down toward heritage houses. The food that you need to try in Ilocos Sur is empanada. One of the striking characteristics of the Batak empanada is the bright orange color. The empanadas are deep fried and stuffed with green papaya, chopped up longanisa sausage, and hard-boiled egg. Number 2 is the longanisa. Longanisa is the emblematic Ilocos food. These pork sausage are the star at any Ilocano's table. For the festival and special event, Tabaco Festival celebrated every last week of March on Candon City as Thanksgiving for City the Bountiful of Tabaco. And being the largest producer of the finest Virginia tobacco in the country. The major industry in Ilocos Sur, the people are engaged in farming, producing food crop, mostly rice, corn, vegetable, root crops, and fruit. Cottage industry include loom weaving, furniture making, jewelry making, ceramic, blacksmithing, and food processing.
So moving on to the third province of Region 1, the La Union. Of course, before going through its major attractions, let's begin to learn about the province itself first. So starting with its history and creation, then the number of municipalities and cities, its geographical features, the languages that locals use, and their major ethnic groups. So back in history, on October 29, 1849, Governor General Cabrera issued a promovido to Vista, Pangasinan, Ilocos, and Cordillera areas into La Union, which means the Union. So it's just an encouragement at first. Until Governor General Antonio Mario Blanco signed the Superior Decreto of La Union on March 2, 1850. Which made the La Union founded as the 34th province since the founding of Cebu in 1565. Then, on April 18, 1854, Isabella II of Spain finally decreed the province creation. Therefore, La Union is created by a royal decree issued by the Spanish Queen Isabella on April 14, 1854. It merges the 9 towns of Pangasinan, 3 of Ilocos Sur, and villages of Benguet in Cordillera. So La Union comprises 19 municipalities and one component city, which are all organized into legislative districts. So under the first district, it is the municipalities inside the White Boxes together with the San Fernando, the capital city of La Union. Then of course, the municipalities inside the Gray Boxes are under the second district. So La Union covers a total area of 1,497.7 square kilometers. And as it was mentioned before, the province is bordered by Ilocos Sur to the north, Benguet to the east, Pangasinan to the south, and to the west by the South China Sea, just like how you see in the picture. So the pictures of the Plakan River, which is along Pugo, that is also near from the Cordillera Mountains, then the landscape along Rosario and the coast along Agu overlooking the South China Sea will help you to visualize what kind of nature the province are bordered of. So moving on to the language and ethnic groups within the province. It is reported that with the total population of La Union, which is 700,000 as of 2015, 92.23% classified themselves as Ilocanos, possibly 9/10 of the total population within the province. And the rest were either Pangani, Tagalog, or Pangasinan. So Ilocanos make up the third largest ethno-linguistic group in the Philippines. The language even has become the lingua franca of northern Luzon, that's why it should be no surprise that almost all of the people in the La Union are Ilocanos. Then Kankane are said to be the Sugata Igorots. It mostly reside in Western Mountain Province, Northern Benguet, and Southeastern Ilocos Sur. Reason for Kankane is not that common in La Union. then Pangasinan is actually the 9th largest ethnic group in the Philippines. But the Pangasinan population is intensive in Lingayen Gulf, Pangasinan Province, and central area of Luzon Island. Reason for their population in La Union is a small number. And last is the Tagalog. Even the Tagalog is one of the largest and most dominant ethnic groups in the country. Most Tagalogs that live outside the NCR are in the provinces of Region 3 and Region 4. That's why their population in La Union is not that much as well. Next is the port access in terms of international gateway, land route, and bus service. Actually, the tourism boom in La Union happens in the year 2010. So what is tourism boom? A tourism boom is a good situation in which a nation becomes particularly attractive to visitors from other countries who spend money in the nation and raise its GDP. So from the mid-2000 to the early 2010, an influx of entrepreneurs began putting up establishments such as boutique-style art hostels and third-wave coffee shops in San Juan and Agu. They were initially attracted to the already established surfacing of barangay or bistondo in San Juan, but eventually envisioned business in the province as an alternative to the stresses of city-based employment. This coincided with the face-by-face opening of the Tarlac, Pangasinan, La Union Expressway, which made La Union more accessible to tourists from Metro Manila. So San Fernando Airport, Partas transportation, and motorcycle taxis, including jeepneys, are the usual mode of transportation that are being used to go in and out in La Union. And finally, the major attractions given in La Union. Of course, including the tourism activities, accommodations, and foods within the province. Let's begin with destinations where you can do surfing since La Union is dubbed as the surfing capital of the North after all. First, the Pebble Beach in Luna, La Union. It is one of the best tourist spots in La Union because pebbles of different sizes cover a long stretch of the beach. Next is the Bawang Beach in Bawang, La Union. It is considered as one of the premier swimming tourist spots in La Union and set in the rugged landscape of Certain Luzon. It offers a magnificent view of the sea and crystal clear waters, which also serve as a fishing ground for the locals. Among the activities, you can also do surfing, boating, snorkeling, fishing, scuba diving, and other different non-activities. Then of course, the Urbistondo Beach in San Juan, La Union. Urbistondo Beach is the primary surfing spot in La Union, and it is also a good spot to learn the sport as there are different school and surfing camps teaching newbies. And here are some you could visit other than those three. You could also do cliff diving, swimming, and trekking in several falls in La Union. There is Tingalan Falls in San Juan, which is one of the most popular eco-based tourist spots. Then Balay Anita Falls in Sentul. That falls is named as such because spirits are said to inhabit the falls. Thus, visitors are advised to offer prayers when coming here. And here are some you could as well visit. Other than beaches and falls, there are also rivers. So, Tapuacan River in Pugo is one of the remotest tourist spots in La Union. Both locals and travelers love coming here because of its pristine waters emanating from the Grand Mountains of the Cordillera region. And other than Tapuacan, there is also Big Spring in Santol and Aburayan River in Sutipan. For those nature lovers who prefer off-beat and tracks, try Lotus Valley Farm in San Juan. It is not a typical farm where you can find rows of trees or crops, but it is a forest farm composed of thousands of flora and fauna species, all integrated naturally in self-sustaining ecosystem. And as well with grape farm in Bawang, you have all the time to pick fresh grapes. It is also recommended to explore and visit all these destinations because it is all worth it either in terms of its view and experience. You must also try the Halo-Halo de Iloco in San Fernando. Because in the Halo-Halo de Iloco restaurant of San Fernando, you can taste one of the best Halo-Halo in the country. What makes this Halo-Halo so delicious is the mix of local ingredients. This includes saging from Abu, ube from San Gabriel, pastillas made from the caramel milk, and the creamy homemade ice cream. While if you're in San Juan, you shouldn't miss trying out an Iloco specialty called Kilawen. This consists of meat like beef, pork, fish, or goat cooked in an unusual method using acidity of vinegar or calamansi. This process makes the meat a lot tastier, and you can find this in Layak Grill and Kilawen Bar of San Juan. Here are some other foods you should try as well. Or you can visit any of these restaurants. If you were to stay longer and need accommodations, La Union could offer affordable or fancy kind of comfort. So there is San Juan La Union Resorts and Hotels, San Fernando La Union Resorts and Hotels, and Airbnb La Union Philippines. You should not also miss out the festival celebrated in La Union if you were to stay. Like Dinengdeng Festival in Abu. Dinengdeng is the most loved dish by Ilocanos in La Union, and every year the locals hold a festival for this dish, and you can expect a lot of cooking contests and lots of food during this festival. The Tobacco Festival in Tubao. Tubao La Union celebrates the Tobacco Festival annually for its bountiful tobacco harvest because the area is known to produce the biggest volume of tobacco in the country, and you would really enjoy a colorful celebration during this festival. The Silog Festival in San Fernando. Silog Festival is a 2-to-3-day event that features lantern parade, musical show, and the ceremonial lighting of the Silog Village in San Fernando, La Union. Next is Bagak Festival in Bawang. Bagak Festival is celebrated yearly in Bawang, La Union. In local terms, Bagak means morning star and represents a new day in Bawang. You'll find here a great show of costumes and portrayal of the Ilocano culture. And last but not the least is the Pinadangan Festival of San Fernando. There will be a most colorful costumes and amazing street dancing during this festival. And finally, here's the proposed tour itinerary for La Union.
Gasinan was discovered by Juan de Salcedo upon the order of his grandfather, Governor General Miguel Lopez de Legazpi, of 1572. Chinese corsair Limahong goes to Pangasinan after he failed to colonize the Manila and establish a little kingdom in Fort of Lingayen from 1574 to August 1575. Year 1580, Pangasinan is organized as Alcudia Mayor, is a Politico Civil Administrative Unit by Governor General Gonzalo Ramquillo. The first alcalde mayor was Don Pedro Manique. Founding year of Pangasinan is April 5, 1580. Pangasinan came from the words Panga Asinan, which means where salt is made, because of all you can find salt there. Pangasinan has 44 municipalities. There are 4 cities: Alamino, San Carlos, Urdaneta, and Dalupan. It is composed of 6 congressional districts. 1,364 barangays. We'll be right back.
The common transportation used to travel within Pangasinan and going out are usually the Gupon bus, tricycle, jeepney, and via T-Plex. Spanish, Jose Palma, in Bautista, Pangasinan.